Hey there, I'm Scott. Welcome back to my home and kitchen. All right, tonight is the night. I'm gonna do the number one most requested video, and that is for Southern biscuits with sausage gravy. Let's head over to the kitchen and get started. All right, the process of making biscuits is not hard. It's essentially a shortbread. The ingredients you'll need for this particular recipe are one packet of active dry yeast and 2 tablespoons of water, preferably at 110 degrees. Really hot tap water will be just fine. 5 cups of all-purpose flour, plus about a cup or so of extra flour. We're going to use that in case we need it if the dough's too wet, but also for flouring our bench. 1 tablespoon of baking powder, 1 teaspoon of baking soda, 1/4 cup of sugar, 1 teaspoon of salt, and here we go, 1 cup of shortening, and 2 cups of buttermilk. All right, so the first thing we want to do is open up our yeast and put that into our warm water. That's going to help a little bit. All right, just put that yeast right into the warm water and just give it a little shake. You just want to activate it, make sure it starts to foam. That's going to give us the lift that we need in this particular recipe. Into the flour, we're going to add our baking powder, our baking soda, the sugar, 1 teaspoon of the salt, and just with the whisk, you want to completely combine this to make sure that all of those dry ingredients are completely well distributed. So all of the dry ingredients are now completely incorporated, well distributed. Take your cup of the shortening. This could be lard, I think, traditionally, of course, in the South. This would have been lard. Today we're choosing vegetable shortening. Get all that in there. Now I'm going to show you guys how to cut this in. To cut this in, I have my shortening right here on the top. I'm just going to take the flour and kind of start piling it up on top. And then we're going to take our fingers and we're just going to start kind of breaking this in to little pea-sized chunks. And I do put my shortening in the refrigerator for about an hour. You can put it in the freezer for, you know, 30 minutes or so, 15 minutes. We just want it pretty well chilled. So we're just going to work this together with our hands, breaking up the flour but incorporating that into the shortening till we get little bitty bits. All right, we're just going to check. This is the size shortening we're looking for. Nice pea-sized, English pea-sized bits of the shortening cut into the flour. Now we're ready to add our wet ingredients. Okay, now we're going to add our yeast, which is active. It foamed up a little bit, so that's going to go right in. Make sure we get it all. And then our 2 cups of the buttermilk. And you could use low-fat buttermilk in this, but with a cup of shortening, really, what's the point? Alright, then with a spatula, we're going to combine this until we get a nice semi-wet dough consistency. With that extra flour, we're just going to take this on a clean surface and just spread a little bit down. Then we're going to turn out our bowl of dough and just knead this a little bit. We don't want to sort of break up all that shortening that we worked so hard to keep in those nice sized chunks. And we're gonna roll this out to about, I would say, 1/2 inch or so thick, and then we'll cut them with the biscuit cutter. Oh, in the meantime, I preheated our oven to 400 degrees. And as I roll this out, I'm just checking to make sure that the dough is not sticking. If it is, I'm gonna lift it up and just spread a little bit of flour underneath it. There we go, that's about 1/2 inch. We are ready to cut them. What I do with a biscuit cutter, you're just going to dip that down in your flour. The technique here is to go straight in. You do not want to twist it because twisting it will prevent it from rising. And I have a sheet pan here. So as they get cut, I'm just gonna move them out right onto our sheet pan. You do wanna keep these spaced probably about half an inch between each biscuit. All of my biscuits are cut out. I did want to talk to you about the scraps. It is okay to roll these together once more and cut those into biscuits. You can also put them into a freezer bag, freeze them for a couple of months, let them come to room temperature, roll them out, and you'll have your biscuits ready to go. Into a 400 degree oven, we're going to put our biscuits for 15 to 20 minutes. Keep an eye on them. You want them nice and toasty brown. While the biscuits are in the oven, this is the time to make the gravy, and it's really simple. In a skillet, we're going to turn it on, medium-high heat. I'm going to add 8 ounces of a breakfast sausage of your choice. I'm just using a ground pork sausage with a kind of a mild flavor to it, a little bit of spice, a little bit. We're going to cook this until it's well browned. I'm just going to break it up with my spoon as it cooks, and we'll get that done, then I'll show you what we do next. Our sausage is completely browned all the way through. That is important. You don't want to mess around with it. In a little bowl here, I'm just going to scrape all of this sausage into the bowl. If you have a lot of extra fat in your skillet, you could do this with a slotted spoon as well, because you want to keep as much oil in the pan as possible. So back onto our heat, I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of shortening again. Goes right in. And once this melts, we'll add a few tablespoons of flour. The shortening is melted. I'm just going to add 3 tablespoons of flour right into the pan. Here we're starting to build our roux, and that's the combination of fat and flour. Let this get all mixed together. Then we're going to add about 1.5 cups of milk. If for some reason your gravy starts to get too thick, you can add just a little bit of milk at a time, like 2 tablespoons at a time. And if you cook your gravy and let it sit for a little while and it thickens, then you would just loosen it up with a little bit of milk and heat it up. So just stir in all of this milk. Really simple. We're going to add a few cracks of pepper. And about 1/8 teaspoon of cayenne pepper. I like the heat. We're going to let this come up to a boil. That's what's going to thicken this. And as soon as it thickens, we can add our sausage in and we're ready to eat. The gravy is just starting to come up to a boil, which is perfect. I'm going to add in our sausage. And I wanted to wait until after I added the sausage to taste it for salt. So once I get all this incorporated, turn the heat way down just to keep it nice and warm, and give this a little taste. And a little pinch of salt would be great. And this is ready to serve. The timer just went off on our biscuits. The gravy's all ready to go. The biscuits look and smell delicious. I really hope you guys will make this. I'm going to pick the best one for my little snack right here. Open that up. Perfect. It's a perfect biscuit. And then we'll see our gravy right over the top. You know what? My mouth is watering right now. This smells so good. I can't even wait. I'm just going to have to take a bite of it. You gotta make it. It's so good. All right, guys, thanks so much for watching. I can see really why so many people wanted this recipe, because every time I make it, I get the same sensation. It's just delicious. Thanks so much for watching. If you have any questions about this video or my other videos, please email me at scottinoregon@comcast.net. And please visit my blog at scotthargrove.blogspot.com. Guys, have a great day and enjoy your summer. Bye.